Hello friends, welcome to Sandip's Biology. In this video, I'll be talking about glyoxylate cycle. Glyoxylate cycle is an anabolic variant of citric acid cycle. It provides an anaplerotic function, which means the intermediates of citric acid cycle which are withdrawn, these intermediates are replenished by glyoxylate cycle. The organisms in which this cycle occurs are plants, bacteria, protists, and fungi. These organisms can convert net carbohydrate from fatty acid without losing carbon atoms. And these organisms can also use acetate as a carbon source. If sugar is not available, then acetate can be used as a carbon source for the various metabolic activities. So here, let us talk about organisms in which this cycle occurs. These are plants, bacteria, protists, and fungi. This cycle do not occur in animals, including human beings. But some animals like nematodes, during early embryogenesis, there are presence of the enzymes of the glyoxylate cycle. So it may be doing, these organisms may be doing glyoxylate cycle during stages of early embryogenesis. Otherwise, in all animals, this cycle is absent. So let us talk about organisms. First is plants and especially germinating seeds, then bacteria, protists and fungi. So these are the organisms in which glyoxylate cycle is present, and as I told you, these organisms can synthesize net carbohydrate from fatty acid without losing carbon atom. And these organisms can also use acetate as a carbon source. For example, bacteria can grow on a medium containing acetate. When sugar is not available in a medium, bacteria can use acetate as a carbon source, right? Location in which this cycle occurs. So inside the cell, specialized peroxysomes are there, which are called glyoxysome, right? So location of this cycle is glyoxysome. Let us talk about common enzymes. So as I told you that these organisms can convert net carbohydrate from fatty acid. To do this kind of conversion, reactions of two cycles occur. One is glyoxylate cycle and second citric acid cycle. So for the net conversion, two cycle operates. One is glyoxylate cycle and second citric acid cycle. So here I indicated these reactions. So this full circle is citric acid cycle and the half circle is glyoxylate cycle. So there are common enzymes of citric acid cycle and glyoxylate cycle as well, right? So here citrate synthase, aconitase and malate dehydrogenase. These are the common enzymes which work in glyoxylate cycle as well as citric acid cycle. Let us talk about key enzymes of glyoxylate cycle, or we can say that unique enzyme to glyoxylate cycle. These enzymes catalyze bypass reaction, right? So here are these two bypass reactions and these two enzymes, isocitrate lyase and malate synthase. These are two key enzymes of glyoxylate cycle. As these reactions are bypass, so isocitrate is directly converted to malate, and these two reactions, which are oxidative decarboxylation reaction, in which carbon atoms are losing. So these two reactions are bypassed, right? So net conversion of carbohydrate from fatty acid is done. Let us talk about compartments. So for the net conversion, two cycles are operating. One is glyoxylate cycle and second is citric acid cycle. So glyoxylate cycle, the reactions of glyoxylate cycle occur inside glyoxysome, and the reactions of citric acid cycle occur inside mitochondrial matrix. So compartments means there are two organelles in which these reaction takes place. Second is mitochondrial matrix or mitochondria. So for the net conversion, these two compartments are needed for glyoxylate cycle and for citric acid cycle. Now let us talk about the net conversion. If seeds are germinating. So during the germination of seed, leaves are not yet produced, and the fat that is stored inside the seed are converted to carbohydrates without losing any carbon atoms, and these carbohydrates can be used for various metabolic needs. For example, synthesis of cellulose. Cellulose is made up of beta D glucose. So this beta D glucose, it means this carbohydrate comes from fatty acid, right? Fatty acid are converted into carbohydrates. And here these reactions are important. These two organelles are important. So first, fatty acid is converted to acetyl coenzyme A. And remember, the glyoxylate cycle occur in glyoxysome, which are specialized peroxysome, right? So fatty acid, which are stored inside the glyoxysome, these are very long chain fatty acid, and these fatty acid, by the process of beta oxidation, converted into acetyl coenzyme A. Acetyl coenzyme A combined with oxaloacetate, right, four carbon containing oxaloacetate, and produce six carbon containing citrate. Enzyme working here is citrate synthase, which is a common enzyme of both the cycles, right? Citrate is then converted to isocitrate, and enzyme working here is aconitase. Isocitrate is converted, actually it is cleaved into two molecules, four carbon containing succinate and two carbon containing glyoxylate, right? So isocitrate is cleaved into these two molecules. Here two carbon containing glyoxylate is produced. That's why this cycle is called glyoxylate cycle. This reaction, that is bypass reaction, it is catalyzed by the key enzyme of glyoxylate cycle, that is isocitrate lyase. Now glyoxylate combined with another molecule of acetyl coenzyme A, and these two molecules produce malate, right? Two carbon containing glyoxylate combines with two carbon containing acetyl coenzyme A, and it produces malate. The enzyme working here is second key enzyme of glyoxylate cycle, that is malate synthase. If you see here, these two steps, which are oxidative decarboxylation reaction, these two are bypassed, and these two carbon atoms, right, which were losing as a carbon dioxide molecule, the loss of the carbon atom is overcome by this bypass mechanism. Now the malate is converted to oxaloacetate, and enzyme working here is malate dehydrogenase. Oxaloacetate is used to run the next cycle, right? So as the cycle runs, there will be production of succinate, four carbon containing succinate. So as the cycle run first time, one molecule of succinate is produced. Cycle runs twice, two molecules of succinate are produced. Succinate is produced inside the glyoxysome. The succinate is transported inside the mitochondrial matrix, right? So this succinate, which is produced inside the glyoxysome, is transported to mitochondrial matrix, where the reactions of citric acid cycle takes place, and it enters into the citric acid cycle. So here the full circle is citric acid cycle. So it enters directly here, and these two oxidative decarboxylation reactions, in which carbon atoms are lost, these two reactions are bypassed, right? Succinate is then converted to fumarate, which is then converted to malate. Malate is converted to oxaloacetate, and oxaloacetate is used to produce glucose. So oxaloacetate is present in mitochondrial matrix. It is then transported to cytoplasm, because the process of gluconeogenesis occur in cytoplasm. So this oxaloacetate is then transported to cytoplasm, and inside the cytoplasm it is converted to glucose by the process of gluconeogenesis. So simply I just indicated succinate, which is produced during glyoxylate cycle, is used to produce glucose. So here net conversion of carbohydrate is there, right? From fatty acid, glucose is produced without losing any carbon atoms, right? So these are the reactions of glyoxylate cycle, this half circle, and this full circle is citric acid cycle. So to do this kind of synthesis of carbohydrate, two cycles are operating. One is glyoxylate cycle inside the glyoxysome, and second is citric acid cycle inside the mitochondrial matrix, right? So this is the significance of glyoxylate cycle. It bypass these two steps, which are oxidative decarboxylation reaction, right? And this organism can use acetate as a carbon source. So acetate is converted to acetyl coenzyme A, and acetyl coenzyme A, by the same way that I discussed earlier, can be used to produce succinate. Succinate can be used to produce glucose, right? By the process of gluconeogenesis, or it can be used to generate ATP, right? It will enter into the citric acid cycle and will generate ATP. So this is glyoxylate cycle. I hope this video is helpful. If you are watching this video till here, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to the channel, and thank you for watching.